far as this question is concerned, Sandeep, because you're talking about the denim industry, and denim industry is so all-encompassing, right from, let's say, the fibers, to the yarns, to the manufacturers, to the distribution, to brands and to retail. So there's a huge amount of churn that the whole industry will go through, and every part of the industry, starting off with retail, and we're seeing what's really happening in the industry. How are the weaker ones really, really sort of going through a lot of aggravation, a lot of Chapter 11 going through. And the fact is that with so many distractions that we've had till now, not distractions, alternate options for consumers, which is right from, let's say, holiday to eating out, to vacations, to cell phones, continuously apparel, including jeans, has, you know, have been losing share to these, you know, to these other industries. So, to be honest, I think as an industry, apparel industry in general, and denim industry in particular, has got a breather. For some time to come, people will not be able to travel. People will not be able to sort of, you know, go to restaurants, or less going to the restaurants. So that corpus is available, or that money is available for the consumers. And let's say jeans, the unit cost of jeans being low, it's about instant gratification at a low cost, right? So I think a very interesting point, Stefano, and the biggest fallout that we have seen in the supply chain of the current pandemic is the problem of cash flows all across, right? Everybody. And I think the biggest source of this cash flow problem has been the inventories. So it's the brands, it's the retailers, it's the supply chain, which is holding onto large inventories, right? And which is driving this whole cash flow problem, which is driving the Chapter 11 discussions and all those issues, right? Now, the thing is that the model itself, I mean, the current model in our industry is sort of, you know, the way it is. About, you know, almost about a year or 12 or 14 or 16 months in advance, you're expecting some people to take a decision on behalf of the consumer as to what is he going to buy, right? Now, that's unfair, it's impossible, it is impractical, right? It's just not possible. So you know, thousands of people trying to take a call on behalf of the customer as to what is he going to buy, and taking those, you know, taking those calls and judgments and producing goods in advance, years in advance, or months in advance, and expecting those goods to sell. So I think that's where the fundamental problem is. And possibly, I don't know, and it's not going to happen overnight. It'll not be an event. But as a continuum, I believe with this experience, with this very sort of, you know, unfortunate experience, possibly one can see a shift in the business model of the industry. So at times, say for example, if you see the automobile industry, right, with whatever has happened to, you know, with the likes of Uber, the industry itself has got disrupted, where from owning assets, right, you're moving into service. People are realizing that, no, there are assets that can run and deliver more value. So rather than you own assets, and it's more convenient, it is less cost. So in our industry also, possibly, there could be this shift towards pull-based supply chain. Right now, it's all being pushed. So you're manufacturing, you're deciding, and you're pushing things to stores and to consumers, and then finally it doesn't sell, and it ends up in the landfill, as you've so rightly said. Possibly, there's a case for a, you know, pull-based industry, and it's power to the consumer, so it's mass, all the things, cool things that we've been hearing about till now, and we thought that they're very in the realms of, let's say, they were more hypothetical. But possibly one is seeing that there's value in this, where it's mass customization, it's manufacturing to the requirements of the consumers, rather than taking calls on behalf of the consumers. And today there are technologies available where, you know, you can produce just one unit, right? So you don't have to produce millions of yards of fabric and stuff like that. So possibly, you know, one could see a shift towards that direction. I personally feel that as an industry, to give a direction to the industry, like if you draw parallels from other industries, for example, automobile industry, has seen a disruption with the coming of electric vehicles, right? EVs. We saw the phone industry going through a huge change when you got smartphones, right? LED television has been able to sort of, you know, disrupt the television industry. So even in our industry, technology, if you see what has happened, some examples, for example, Carlos from Genealogy is here, right? What laser has done to the industry? It has really disrupted the whole garment finishing part of the industry, right? So it's way more sustainable, it's way more efficient, less losses, lower costs. So I think technology, and today there are multiple technologies which one can see in our industry, right? From, you know, dyeing in a very, very efficient manner with very, very low costs and with very sort of, you know, let's say very sustainable manner, to recycling, to multiple things that we're seeing in our industry. And I personally feel that this technology has a power of being able to make the industry more efficient, more sustainable, right? Bring down costs as well, and reduce wastages. So this whole thing about using technology, that's to me is one important part in the industry. So because then it can take the industry to the next level, it can give a new direction to the industry, and all these things will form a subset of that. So sustainability, circularity, all these things will be a subset of that. That's one point. The other thing is that I believe in our industry, we have got some great design people, right? Very, very good design talent. We've got some very good operations talent, merchandising talent, management, right? So the managerial part of the industry, because for the industry to create value, you know, attracting good talent to the industry. So like you have talent get going to other industries and creating disproportionate value in the industry. Unfortunately, as an industry, we've not been able to attract great talent where we have been able to create value, you know, for the stakeholders. So if you end up doing that, then more capital will flow to the industry, more money is going to flow to the industry. People will start seeing this industry as creating a lot of value. So these are a few things that came to my mind when I thought I'd share.